You know times are rough when they're actually resurrecting an almost 3-year-old graphics card. But the rumors turned out to be true, and now it's official. There will be a brand new 12GB RTX 2060. Let's get straight to the point, as we have to cover four main areas. First, we will talk about the specs and see how it compares to the original 2060 and the 2060 Super. Then we will look at what kind of performance we can actually expect. Next up is pricing. And last but not least, I will explain why Nvidia is reviving such an old GPU. Taking a look at the specs, we can see that the new 12GB RTX 2060 is a mix between the original 2060 and the 2060 Super that came after it. With 2176 cores, it has the same amount of shaders as the 2060 Super, and the same goes for the ray tracing and tensor cores, and also for the TMUs and ROPs. Although the memory setup, we are not 100% sure about the ROPs yet. The clock speeds are also the exact same as the 2060 Super, so far it looks like the new 12GB 2060 and the 2060 Super are exactly the same, but the way they start to differ is when we take a look at the memory system. The new 12GB 2060 uses the same exact memory setup as the original 2060, only with twice the capacity for the memory chip, so we get 12GB instead of 6GB. But that means that the new version also uses the small 192-bit memory interface instead of the full 256-bit interface of the 2060 Super. And since all three versions of the 2060 use the same 14GB per second GDDR6 memory, the new 12GB version will also have the reduced memory bandwidth of only 336GB per second. To be honest, that's a decision I do not understand myself, because I would much rather have a 8GB version of the card with the faster 448GB per second of bandwidth instead of having the full 12GB but with the slower 336GB of bandwidth. Maybe there's a production advantage when using the smaller memory interface, or Nvidia just has a lot of the high capacity chips laying around. We don't know yet, but there has to be a reason why Nvidia is going this route. When it comes to performance, the new 12GB 2060 should perform closer to the 2060 Super than the original 2060, because most of the specs are actually the same as the 2060 Super, but it's hard to gauge how much of an impact the lower memory bandwidth will have. On top of that, the increased VRAM capacity might also give you a performance uplift in some certain games, and especially in higher resolutions. If you don't remember how the 2060 Super performed, or it's hard for you to place it in today's lineup, you can expect about the performance of the RX 6600 or maybe 10% behind a RTX 3060. So at least for 1080p, still a pretty good performance tier, and if Nvidia actually manages to produce a lot of those cards, it could help a lot of gamers to finally get a graphics card they can use for gaming. Of course, the RTX 2060 also supports ray tracing, but I really wouldn't expect much, especially when it comes to the actual frames per second you will get when enabling ray tracing. What does come in handy is the tensor cores the card has, because that will enable it to use DLSS, which might elevated to a 4040p performance card. Because if you think about it, with a 12GB VRAM and the ability to run DLSS, this card will perform a lot better than you might expect of a 3-year-old graphics card. On top of that, AMD's FSR and Intel's upcoming XESS are also open source, so those will also be compatible with the 12GB 2060, which means that you're buying an older graphics card, but using all that new tech, you may have more fun than you think. And that's also why I think that this move might be a really good one from Nvidia, because you're not only getting a older graphics card resurrected, but this graphics card supports all the latest APIs with DirectX 12 and ray tracing. It has enough VRAM for the coming generations, and with all the support from software, like we just talked about it, I think the life expectancy of this card might be longer than you think. Now, all of these positive points won't mean anything if the prices are sky high like with the rest of the graphics cards. And if you think that an older graphics card resurrected should be a lot cheaper, then you have to think again. Nvidia told The Verge, and I'm quoting here, "It's a premium version of the RTX 2060 6GB, and we expect the price to reflect that." Yes, they just called the 12GB version of an almost 3-year-old 2060 a premium version. I still think we will see an MSRP below the 3060. Anything else wouldn't really make sense, but don't expect this to be a $200 graphics card. My guess would be a $299 MSRP, which is $30 below the 3060. That actually costs a lot more when you buy it right now. But I'm just shooting my shot here in the dark. We have to wait until the official announcement to be sure. Initially, there was also a Founders Edition announced on Nvidia's website, but this has been removed so far, and now Nvidia is communicating that the new 12GB 2060 will be a part partner card release only, which is kind of a shame in my opinion, because that would have been a way to directly sell to customers for MSRP. And if Nvidia is able to produce a lot of those cards, that would have been really great for a lot of gamers that have been waiting for a graphics card release that they can actually purchase and afford at the same time for quite a while now. With a partner card release only, we're already at the mercy of the partners. And you know what they like to do? They like to check up the prices. Now that we've talked about the specs, the performance, and the possible pricing, the only question left is, why is Nvidia actually bringing back such an old GPU? Why not just produce more RTX 3060s, for example? If you watch this channel or if you've been following tech news in general, you know about the ongoing chip shortage. Currently, all semiconductor manufacturers are at full capacity and they just can't produce more stuff in general. Nvidia is using a Samsung's 8nm process for their current gen Ampere GPUs, AMD is using TSMC's 7nm process for their RDNA 2 GPUs, and even Intel's upcoming Arc GPUs will be produced by TSMC's in their 6nm process. But the RTX 2060 is designed on Turing, to be more precise on the TU106 chip, which is a 12nm design. Yes, it is still produced by TSMC, but the older nodes are not as affected by the high demand as the newer nodes, so there might be a lot more capacity left when you're using something like 12nm. This is most likely also the reason why they're still sticking with the slower 14GB per second GDDR6 memory, because all the newer graphics cards use faster memory chips or even GDDR6X, so there's a lot more capacity when you're using the older stuff. They might even have a lot of those older chips still in storage. Re-releasing the RTX 2060 in 2021 is a really smart move by Nvidia to produce a cheap GPU, circumventing current supply issues by using the old production node, using the slower, older GDDR6 memory, and still producing a capable GPU. And on top of it, in today's market, they might actually make a lot of money with it too. I have to say, I really like the idea of a new old RTX 2060. Of course, it's sad that we're in this kind of situation to begin with, but using older nodes and older chips to circumvent current supply issues is really ingenious by Nvidia. My only fear is that even if this card will be widely available, that the current market will just inflate prices to infinity again and you will be paying more for a graphics card in 2021 than you paid for it in 2019. My question for you is, would you actually consider buying a new 12GB RTX 2060? And if so, what's your price limit? Let me know down in the comments below. As always, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe for more content, and see you in the next video.